Hello, welcome everyone. Today is lecture 5 and we are looking at mergers, acquisitions and takeovers. Just a recap on what we are discussing the previous lecture. We were trying to look at the step that deals with strategy formulation in the process of strategic management. And we discussed quite a number of things ranging from understanding the definition of strategy, understanding the levels of strategy, that there are those three levels, corporate level strategy, business level strategy, functional strategy, and then we explained what is involved at each of those levels in terms of formulation. In a nutshell, we are saying strategy formulation is just that process now of developing a comprehensive master plan for the organization as you manage your environmental elements. Okay, so let's consider the mergers, acquisitions, and takeovers. We'll start by just understanding these three terms. What are mergers? What is a merger? A merger is a strategy through which two firms agree to integrate their operations. So we have a situation where two firms come together, agree to integrate or combine their assets, their operations. That is a merger. So no one has got control over the other. You have agreed to combine your assets, and that's a merger strategy. We see these things very often in the business world. But we also have what is called an acquisition. What is an acquisition strategy? Coming from the term acquire. To acquire is to buy something. So this is a situation where one firm will buy a controlling or 100% interest in another firm with the intent of making that firm one of the subsidiary companies in that holding company. So here we have a different scenario where one firm gets control or they buy the controlling interest of that organization and you make it a subsidiary business within the portfolio. So that is an acquisition. Whereas in a merger, you have the scenario where two firms A and B agree to combine their assets, integrate their operations so that they come up with a firm that is large. Then the other term that we have here is the takeovers. Takeover. Now, a takeover is another special type of acquisition wherein the target firm does not solicit the acquiring firm's bid, and in most cases, these takeovers are considered to be unfriendly acquisitions. So we have company A wanting to take over company B, and in this case, company B may not even be for the idea of being taken over by this company A. And that's why in some cases, they are referred to as hostile takeovers. So a bit different from a merger. With a merger, there's an agreement. Two firms agree to combine their assets. With an acquisition, one firm acquires another one. A takeover, we have a scenario where another form of an acquisition where this company that is buying another company may not even get the views of that company that is being acquired or a target firm, whether they are for the idea or not. And I'll explain later how that is done when we are discussing the takeovers. So a company aiming at a hostile takeover can approach this in two major ways. There are two approaches that are used. You can go for a takeover by offering what we call a tender offer. Another method could be a proxy fight or a proxy battle, as others may call it. Now, what is a tender offer? This happens when a group of investors offer to purchase the majority shares of the target company by offering what we call a premium price or a market price. So what will normally happen is that these shareholders of this company that wants to take over another, they will approach the board of directors in that company, say company B, and try to convince them, offer them a premium price so that they can take over that company. The board of directors in most cases may even reject that offer. When that happens, these investors or shareholders that want to buy this company may even go to the shareholders of that company when they don't get a deal from the board of directors. Now, when it reaches the shareholders, as long as the majority shareholders in that company agree, they buy in that idea of being taken over, that transaction can take effect. So that is what we call a tender offer. So we have these investors or a company that wants to buy another company, going to the board of directors, they give them an offer. Normally they will offer a premium price or a market price. If they fail to get the deal at that level of the board of directors, then they actually go to the shareholders, the owners of that company, and offer them that deal. Once the majority shareholders are agreeable to that offer, then that takeover will actually take effect. The other approach that is used is a proxy fight. With a proxy fight, this is just an unfriendly way of fighting and controlling that organization. Okay? So on the other hand, this is a rather unfriendly fight of control over an organization. And that's why in most cases we say these takeovers are unfriendly. From the description, you are not even getting the views of these people. You offer them a premium price and you control that company. Now, what are some of the reasons for acquisitions? In this presentation, I want you to concentrate on the acquisitions. I just started by giving you a description of all these three terms, and a merger, an acquisition, and a takeover. But let's zero in on the acquisitions. Why do companies decide to buy other companies or just get 100% control of another company? There are various reasons that have been presented that necessitate, you know, these strategies of acquisition. The first one is just increased market power. Maybe this company may want to have a big market share, okay, or go in areas where your presence is not there. So you want to have market power or control of the market in a particular sector. That could be one of the reasons why companies pursue an acquisition strategy, is to increase your market power. The second one is to overcome entry barriers. You may have industries that are very competitive. In the previous presentations, we were discussing Porter's Five Forces model when we were analyzing the competitive environment. And we learned that one of the forces that Porter identified was the potential entrant of the threat of this potential new entrant. And we say that when these newcomers come in an industry, they come in with one objective of getting the market share. They bring in a product whose price is lower and the value that is appreciated, or the quality that is appreciated by the customers. But then we also learned that the existing firms in that industry will not just sit. They will erect what we call barriers to entry. So one of the reasons why companies pursue acquisition strategies is to overcome some of those entry barriers. So you just buy a company that is already existing in that particular industry, and that's one way of penetrating or entering that industry. So one reason is to overcome those entry barriers that may be put up by companies that are in a particular industry that is attractive. Another reason is to look at the cost of new product development. Now, in developing a new product, you incur a lot of costs. we know companies normally go through what you call a 9-step process in new product development, starting with the idea generation. You screen that idea, you analyze, test that idea, whether it can work, until you get to full commercialization of a new product. Now, to cut down on all those costs involved in developing a new product, the easiest way that companies find is just to acquire a business that is already existing in a particular market, and then you may modify a product and take over that company. So you don't want to go through the costs of coming up with a new product and going in a market with a new product. One way is just to acquire a business and start producing that product. Another one is just to have increased the speed to market entry. It's an easiest way of entering new markets. Instead of going in and setting up a new company, just acquire a company that is already existing. Very much related to the first one, where we are talking about increasing market share. So it's one way of getting into new markets very, very fast. Another reason is to lower the risks compared to product, developing new products. Now, in developing new products, you don't just incur the cost, as is the case in number two, but there are also risks. When we talk about risks here, we are simply referring to the uncertainties that may be there, the likelihood that this product may not even succeed. So there are probabilities here. You are taking chances in developing a new product. So rather than going for a new product development and get all the risks associated and the costs associated with new product development, most companies find acquisitions as the easiest way, because you are buying a company that is already existing, and then you can start developing that product that is already on the market, it's been tested on the market. So you lower the risk of developing a new product, and you do that by just acquiring a business. Acquisitions can also be used for purposes of diversification. Okay, you diversify your business, you go into areas that are totally new. Now, when you talk of diversification as a growth strategy, we have two types. We have what we call related diversification and unrelated diversification. So especially when you talk about unrelated diversification, so a company may go into totally new business lines. And you do that by buying a company that is in that particular line of business. So it's one way to diversify through acquisition strategies. Or you may just want to reshape your competitive scope. Okay, you want to be more competitive, and especially if you discover that this company is making more money, they are a threat. One way of just reshaping your competitive scope is to acquire that business. Now, I remember some time back in the 90s in Zambia, and on the Copperbelt province, to be more specific, there was a company in Indola that came up with an idea of packaging the soft drinks in plastic containers that were disposables. Now, in the past, whenever you wanted to buy a soft drink, people needed to have empty bottles. So you go with an empty bottle and then you exchange, you buy your drink. Now, that did not go well, especially with the traveling, public. So this company came up with that idea. This company was called Invesco Bottling Company. They are producing products like Godspot, Limca, and all those products. And they were packaging them in small containers. Now that gave the Copperbelt Bottling Company a lot of competition, the company that was producing Coca-Cola then. So what did they do to kill that competition and to have enlarge their competitive scope? They just acquired that company, because that company had the facilities, and they started packaging their Coca-Cola in plastic containers in Indola. It was even labeled there, bottled under Invesco. So one way you can reshape your competitive scope is to acquire a business that may be giving you some competition. And companies do that in business, it's done that way. Then another one could be learning and developing new capabilities. When you acquire another business, you may learn new capabilities that you do not have, skills that you do not have, approaches or systems, processes that you do not have. So it's one way of learning and developing new capabilities. These and many other factors, reasons that you may bring, are some of the major reasons why companies pursue this strategy of acquiring another company. Another important aspect on this topic is to understand some of the problems associated with achieving acquisition success. It may not be easy, it may not be smooth. There are challenges that companies normally incur in achieving acquisition success, and I just want us to run through some of those problems. Problem number one is integration difficulties. Remember, we are saying we have two companies, and as you acquire another company, or even in terms of mergers, these problems apply. You have companies that are coming from two different backgrounds. Management style is different, the culture is different, the way things are done is different. So you have these difficulties in terms of integration. And it takes time for the two companies just to move in the same direction, especially in the area of culture and management style. Because every company has got its own ideology, philosophies, and the way they do things. So there are these difficulties to do with integration. The other one is inadequate evaluation of the target firm. So if company A is trying to acquire company B, even where you engage consultants, business experts to do an appraisal, an evaluation of that company, research actually shows, even in practice, it is evident that at times you may not do a thorough evaluation of that company. You may not even understand why maybe the owners of this company are very keen to sell that business. So there's that inadequacy in terms of evaluation of the target firm. You only discover some of the weak points of that business when you have already acquired and you are running that business. So at a distance, it is very difficult to do all the due diligence that you need, the background check of that company, the way it makes profits, and the bad times and the good times. Some businesses are just seasonal. So there's that inadequate evaluation of the target firm, which has been cited as one of the challenges or problems that you encounter in achieving acquisition success. The other one is that you may buy a company that has got an extraordinary debt. Okay, or this company has got a debt which is huge. They are trying to run away from certain obligations. So once you buy that company, you actually take over the debt. I remember some time back in Zambia when Lap Green in Libya bought 75% shares in Zamtel. They took over all the debt, burden, and the liabilities of the company. So you cannot run away to say, no, this is not ours. It was created by the previous owners. When you buy such a company, you take over all the liabilities. And where there is an extraordinary debt, that may be a challenge to achieve success. So managers also may be overly focused on acquisitions. They want to make sure that the process runs smoothly, and you ignore other functions that you carry out as managers. You know, as managers, you're expected to plan, you're expected to organize the activities, direct, go through all those functions of management. But managers may be overly focused on the process of acquisition and may ignore the other critical functions that you have to carry out in an organization. The company may become too big. Okay, much as we know that the size of the company, if it's too big, you enjoy some economies of scale. But again, you may have challenges just in terms of coordination and management of that organization. The company may become too big. You take on a lot, okay? And that may also be a challenge when it comes to the success of that transaction. Or just the inability to achieve synergy. Maybe as you came up with those intentions of acquiring this business, in your mind, you knew that by combining our capabilities, the output will actually be big. We're going to make a lot of money and we're going to achieve higher levels of growth in terms of sales and profitability. That may not just work. That synergy may not just be achieved, and that may create problems in the long run. Or you may diversify too much. Remember, we said one of the reasons could be that you want to diversify. You want to go in areas where you are not yet there. That diversification may be too much. And especially if it is unrelated, you may require new skill sets to handle the new businesses that you are embarking on. So too much diversification may also be a challenge on your part in terms of achieving acquisition success. And that's why most businesses nowadays, like we said earlier on, they want to be masters and specialists in a certain line of business. You don't want to be all over. You may end up overtraining, where you want to do so many activities with very little resources, and that may pose challenges for a particular business. Okay, so today's lecture was very short. I just wanted us to address this issue of mergers, acquisitions, and takeovers, because they form part of the strategies that companies pursue. Now, in the next presentation, we are now going to move on to another important aspect of strategy implementation. We have done environmental scanning, we have done strategy formulation, we are now moving on to issues of implementation. How do we ensure that the strategy that we have formulated, whether at corporate level, whether at business level, whether a functional strategy, whether a strategy to buy another company, a strategy to merge, how do we ensure that we achieve successful implementation of that strategy? So there are certain aspects that must be considered, and we are going to discuss that in the next presentation. Thank you for your attention.